If you're listening to this, you're a human. You're in this Earth, planet called Earth. You know how hard it is for you to be here, bro? The chances of you being born was basically zero. 8 billion people had to be in a room, and the 8 billion people had to roll a dice with 2 million faces, and the 8 billion people had to get the same fucking face. That is the chances of you fucking being born. It's absolutely nuts. And yet you are here being an ungrateful motherfucker because you have a belly, because you're broke, because you don't have the latest fucking Ferrari. Are you fucking serious, bro?
South Memphis nigga ballin', I get every penny. Yeah. 20 pointers in my mouth, they shout out to my dentist. Yeah. I just did a meet and greet and signed a couple titties. If a nigga play with Key, yeah, it's gonna be a killing. Hit that little bitch from the back.
Life is the best movie. When I was washing dishes, I was like, this is the best movie ever, bro. I'm just building the best movie. This is gonna be massive. This is gonna be epic. This is gonna be like a real movie. And like, you just build that plot, you know, just every day you're writing. Like, you know, you're literally writing your script. You can literally decide in any moment, anything, and any decision can be decisive to your destiny. And it's just so exciting that you don't even wanna sleep.
God created you with a very specific mission that it's irreplaceable. It cannot be replaced by anyone. You need to stop wasting your time, really understand which are the gifts that God gave you, and start using them to find your purpose and your mission in life.
You see us pulling up in the Bugatti with the Ricci, flying jet, but I don't need that shit. We have it because, you know, it's fun. We're fucking happy going to the gym and fucking eating our meals in a bench. We're happy at that moment. You're watching this shit in your shit apartment with your shit belly, and you don't like anything about your life, and you think like adding money, it's just gonna magically make you happy. No, bro, removing your fucking belly, your vices, and living in the moment is gonna make you happy. And then by being that and acting with love, you're gonna attract the result that's like the watch, the car.
People think successful is just money. That's not successful. You need to be successful around every area of your life. Health the first, you need to be in shape. You know, relationship the second. You need to have like quality relationships around you. Spiritually, you need to be connected with who you are. And then the last one is the money. But understand this, every successful person I've met, that is very few, all of these people really, really actually believe and feel they have the best fucking life.
Work as if you have everything you want and need in life. When you do that, you're going to be working from gratitude, from love, from good intention, from abundance. It's already out there. Everything you want and need, whenever you're gonna want it or need it, it's gonna be given to you by one of these thousands of people that are gonna be benefit from that daily work that you are putting. That's how I did it. That's how all my students do it. You have to be focused in you. You have to be working like I just told you.
People just walk by now down, they're like seeing the Bugattis. Oh my God, the Bugatti. Oh, what do you do? It's not what do you do, bro. It's like who I am. You don't need to copy the personality of someone. You just need to understand what he's doing, what he's thinking. And that's the way you can actually change your reality.
2017, I came to Miami, rented the cheapest fucking Hyundai, $30 a day, because I couldn't afford more. Stay like 45 minutes from Miami in a shit fucking Airbnb. And I was driving the fucking shit bucket with like, everything was the shittiest thing, Miami lifestyle. I was driving the bridge of Hibiscus, and I was like, one day we're gonna have a mansion there. I told my wife, now we have it. I've done everything I said.
You can really create whatever you wanna fucking live. If you have it in your mind, and you decide this, you know, you think it's possible in your mind, you have faith, and you put the word out there, and you put the action, it's gonna materialize. When, if you're worried about when, that's because you're just doing it for the money. The key thing, everything I did was with love. So when you do with love and faith, you go anywhere. What's the fear option? Oh, I'll buy a building, safe. Say, fuck that, I love myself, I'll buy a Bugatti. I better myself every fucking time. I'll put everything in a line day in, day out, because I know who I am, I'll make it again. That's the big difference, you know, people just gotta build that man that, you know, actually bet on himself. The thing is that people that are watching this, maybe, they're like, oh, like, I want a Lambo, you know, I want a Bugatti, I want a fly jet, private jet, I want a hot-ass chick. I'm like, bro, you don't deserve that shit. You haven't suffered. People just don't suffer. I wake up every day in a mansion, and I work harder than any broke guy that's watching this shit. Like, I work harder than any of these motherfuckers out there. I work all day. I'm driving the Bugatti, I'm working. It's literally, like, all day. If you're not passionate about something and you do it with love, it's never gonna work. Some people say, well, like, I don't have a passion, or like, I don't know what's my purpose. Mm-hmm. So, bro, everyone's purpose is creating the person they admire and respect. So now I was like a little skinny guy. I admire the guy that was tatted. It was fucking Jack. I have the Bugatti, the fucking Lambo, the mansion, the jet. That's what I admired. So that's what I became. I became that, and now I'm just offering it to the world. Like, I don't even think about myself. If I think about myself, oh, I'm tired. I'm lazy. If I'm lazy, I feel tired. Just do another workout. Just pump it up.
The highest vibration, it is authenticity. That's the highest vibration you could be at, being authentic. Whoever you are, just be that person. Just be the best at being you. Don't try to be me. Don't try to be that other guy. If I came all the way here, it's because I am fucking good, really good at being Llados. Every time you do drugs or you're taking drugs, you're risking like your life, literally. You're risking ending in jail, ending dead. People don't understand drugs are gonna take you a very bad path. Are gonna take you to take very bad decisions and can put you in very bad spots very fucking fast, you know, anywhere, anytime. So every time you're doing drugs, have drugs with you, just know you're risking your life. And it doesn't make any fucking sense. Me, after doing everything in life, after buying everything, accomplishing more than what I ever dreamt, I can tell you that the best thing that has happened to me is my wife, the love I have, the love we have. So if you don't have it, it's because you haven't earned it yet. You need to still work on yourself so fucking hard, give 100% every day, and it will come the day that God sends you your angel. Because the love of your life, bro, is the woman that God makes for you. It's out there. It's like money. Bro, you want to make $1 million? Cool. It's already out there, bro. The $1 million is already out there. The money is there. It's just waiting for you to fucking attract it. Same with the love of your life. The love of your life, bro, it's already out there. She is out there. You just need to work on yourself so God makes you guys cross paths. And trust me, when you cross paths, you will know, she will know. What advice would you give to 16-year-old Llados? Bro, stay away from parties, drugs, and people that party and do drugs. Hit the gym every day, you know, follow your macros, and literally pay attention only to one person, and that person has to be the person that is living the life that you want to live. You will absolutely fucking smash it to a level that you cannot even fucking imagine. Work your ass off, one job, two jobs, three jobs. Use all that money, invest it in yourself, and get as close as possible as that person that is living the life that you want to live. If you do what I just told you right now, bro, when you are 18 in 2 years' time, you will not even fucking believe your life. You cannot even imagine.
My routine every day is sacrifice. Yep. Wake up 4:30 a.m. every day. I work out twice a day. I read every day. I write every day. I document everything. I don't party. I don't do drugs. I don't miss a single day. People think that's hard. I mean, for me, it would be hard to have a belly, have tits, and be broke. That would be hard. I love to suffer. It's the only way of going forward. Suffering. God doesn't choose the prepared ones. He chooses and then he prepares. It's all preparation. You prepare, you just gotta suffer. You gotta suffer. You gotta eat trash, you know? I just go anywhere and I'm faith. It's like, oh shit. So if I hit the gym, I can look like that? So if I work hard, I can wear this watch? Oh shit. So if I wake up 4:30 a.m. every day, I can live in that fucking mansion? Yeah, motherfucker. That's faith. That's your duty, bro. You need to like kill it in every area, yeah. Because you need to be an offering to the world. You need to be a walking billboard of what is possible. If you have faith, if you work with love, and if you're authentic.
I was walking in the street. This guy, young kid, came to me, changed his life with his mom. And his mom was like literally nearly crying. And she was like, you've done what I couldn't haven't done in all my life. Like, she was literally in tears. Why did that kid listen to what I said? That was the same thing that her mom was telling him. Because I was that man. I had that life that he wanted. So when I told him that, it just got straight to his soul. And he just took the decision of stop the vices, wake up early, hit the gym. So you're watching this video can be your pinpoint. Now you can just take the decision, like, I'm dropping that drink. I'm waking up 5 a.m., 4 a.m. every fucking day, and I'm not missing. Because look what you can build, what man can build. It's not the material stuff, it's like who we are.
One thing you can do to get out your mind of those external problems is exercise. Suffering, you know, get a crazy workout. Push-ups, burpees, gym, not a little bit, just go super hard. Do 500 burpees. Oh, I can't do it. Yeah, you fucking can't do it. Just go and do it. When you go past that physical line that you think you can't go past, you're gonna disconnect from your body and you're gonna connect with your soul.